My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome all of you to this Amrutvani TV program in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And I am thankful to you for watching this program. For the past few days, I have been sharing a series of threes about three different aspects of Christian life and other topics. Today also, I would like to share about three characteristics of a true Christian. Three characteristics of a true Christian based on the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verses 2 to 10 from the Holy Bible. My dear brothers and sisters, you know the great man of God, Apostle Paul, who wrote several letters to the churches and individuals in the New Testament. He wrote especially seven letters to seven different churches of New Testament, starting with Romans, then Corinthians, then Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians and Thessalonians. These are the churches which Paul addressed through his letters. Out of all these seven churches, one church which was at Thessalonica was an outstanding church. Outstanding in its witness, outstanding in its works, outstanding that it was in the will of God. That's why Apostle Paul appreciated the church and he wrote a letter of encouragement to the church. I would like to read for you one verse from 1 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 3, which is the main theme of our program today. I will read that verse for you. Remembering without ceasing your work of faith, labor of love and patience of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ in the sight of our God and Father. Here, the great Apostle Paul is writing about three things in which the Thessalonian church was outstanding. That is, in faith, number two in love, number three in hope. But if you notice this, that verse carefully, you will see each and every word is joined with a verb. For example, your work of faith. He is not simply saying faith. He is saying work of faith. Secondly, labor of love. Third one, patience of hope. Now, these are the true qualities of a Christian. Now, when we think about Christian, we have got several ideas. We think Christian is a person who has a Christian name. Christian is a person who or she may be wearing a cross. Christian is a person who go to church every Sunday. He or she may be reading Bible, praying, worshipping, giving good, giving alms to people, doing good works, etc., etc. But according to Bible, we see in this letter to Thessalonican church, what are the three main characteristics of a true Christian? Now we will see one by one all these three aspects of a true Christian. First one is work of faith. Apostle Paul is simply not telling about faith. Your faith is so great, your faith is good, this and that. Of course, he has written about faith in several of his letters. But here, to the church at Thessalonica, he is saying that you are doing work of faith. That means your faith is working. Your faith is evident. Your faith is outstanding. Your faith is seen by people. Your faith is not limited like modern day Christians to only Sundays. Your faith is not limited to only the four walls of the church building. But your faith is seen by other people. That's why he writes in the same chapter of 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, saying like this, verse 6 onwards, and you became followers of us and of the Lord, having received the word in much affliction with joy of the Holy Spirit, so that you became examples to all Macedonia and Achaia who believe. Because of their work of faith, they became an example for all other believers in Macedonia and Achaia and other parts of that world. So their faith was evident. Their faith was a shining faith. Their faith was not a dead faith. In James, in the book of James, in the Holy Bible, chapter 2, verses 19 to 22, it says like this. I will read few verses for you. James says like that, but do you want to know, O foolish man, that faith without works is dead? Verse 20. Was not Abraham our father justified by works when he offered Isaac his son on the altar? Verse 22. Do we see that faith was working together with his works, and by works faith was made perfect? In other place, we read in Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9, we are saved not by our works, but by faith through the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. But here we are seeing, faith without works is dead. We are not saved by our good works. But after our salvation, we need to do good works. We need to serve God and serve people also. We need to go out into the world and share the good news of gospel and love of God. We need to have a faith which works. Our faith should not be limited faith. Our faith should not be only Sunday faith. Our faith should not be only a faith in certain occasions. I heard about a story about one place which had no rains for a long time. So some believers, Christians, gathered for a day of fasting and prayer, and they wanted to go into a nearby forest jungle and fast and pray and wait on the Lord for the rains. So when everybody was going, there was a small child, kid, was going in that crowd, and he had an umbrella. And it was very hot. There was no rains or anything. And when the child was carrying the umbrella, some people made fun of him. They said, "Boy, why you are carrying umbrella? There are no rains. We are going to fast and pray for rains. And you are carrying an umbrella." That boy laughed at them and said, "I am carrying umbrella because when we fast and pray, I know God will send rain. There will be a great rain. So I don't want to get myself wet. So I am carrying this umbrella." This is a simple illustration of faith which works. The boy had a faith that when we fast and pray, God will listen to our prayer and He will bless us with rain. That is what faith which works. Dear brothers and sisters, we need a faith which works. And second aspect of true Christian is a labor of love. Here, Apostle Paul is not simply telling love, love, love. He has written a beautiful chapter in New Testament about love in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. But he is not simply telling about love only. He is telling that love which labors. My dear brothers and sisters, true love is a love which labors, which takes time and trouble for others. In the John's Gospel chapter 3 verse 16, the Lord Jesus Christ said like this, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish but have everlasting life." For God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten, beloved Son. God loved the world. How we know? He gave His only beloved Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, as a sacrifice for our sake. True love labors. True love sacrifices. True love gives. True love serves people. That's what Apostle Paul is telling the church at Thessalonica. Your love is a laboring love. My dear brothers and sisters, in the New Testament, the word love in Greek language has three different words. In English, we have love. In our vernacular languages like prem, pyar. But in Greek language, the word love has three different words. The first word is philio, that is mutual love. Love between husband and wife, love between parents and children, love between brother and sister, love between close relations. It is a mutual love. If a person loves, we love. It is a philio. It is a natural love. And there is another word for love in Greek, that is eros. It means lust, greed, calm, moh, getting something out of another person. We see this kind of love in the movies and serials. It is like, you know, getting out of something out of another person, forcefully. If you love me, I will love you. If you don't love me, I will kill you. This is the philosophy of the world. That is eros. And there is another word for love in Greek, that is agape. Agape means divine, sacrificial, selfless, giving love, serving love. This is the love which Apostle Paul is talking about the Thessalonian believers. A true Christian's trademark is love. How can we know a person is a true Christian? The way he loves God and loves others. The great commandment the Lord Jesus Christ told in Matthew 22 verses 37 to 40 is that you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul and with all your mind, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself. This is the two aspects of the love. When we look at the cross, there are two planks. One is vertical plank, one is the horizontal plank. What does the vertical plank reminds us? It tells us that we have to love God above everybody, with all our heart, with all our soul, with all our mind. What does the horizontal plank tells us? We have to love our neighbor as ourselves. We have to love fellow human beings as ourselves. That is what the love which labors. My dear brothers and sisters, the third aspect of true Christian is patience of hope. Apostle Paul is not simply telling that you have hope, but he is telling you are very much patient in having hope. Now we are living in a generation digital world. Everywhere we see ATM, everything is quick, bullet trains, jet planes. We want everything instantly at the touch of a button. We don't have patience. We don't wait. Waiting is boring. Waiting is unbearable for us. We are living in such a age. But Apostle Paul is telling, we need to have patience. The believers at Thessalonica, they had patience in hope. Thessalonican church was the only church commanded by Paul which was waiting for the second coming or rapture of the Lord Jesus Christ. They were waiting in their own generation that Jesus Christ is going to come back again and rapture them to heaven. They had that blessed hope. They were waiting eagerly for the Lord's coming. But Apostle Paul says to them, you have hope, that is good, but you also have patience in hope. You are patiently waiting for the Lord. You are doing the gospel work. You are sharing the good news. You have not limited your faith to yourself. You are waiting for the Lord's second coming patiently. My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord Jesus Christ told us 2000 years back that I will come quickly. What does it mean quickly? 2000 years have passed away. Many skeptics, many doubters, they say, he didn't come for 2000 years. What, he will come? When he will come? But we need to wait patiently. For God, 1000 years is like one day. So, God is patiently working in our midst. The Lord Jesus Christ said in John's Gospel, chapter 14, verses 1 to 3, do not be your heart troubled. You believe in God, believe in also in me. I am going to my Father's house where there are so many mansions for you. I am preparing for a mansion for you. When I will come back, I will take you along with me. Now the question is that 2000 years have passed away. The Lord Jesus Christ said, I will prepare a place for you, for the bridegroom. bridegroom preparing place for the bride. Now we will have a doubt whether he has prepared a place or not. It took 2000 years, but someone said he has prepared the place. Now he is preparing the bride. The bride is not ready. The bride is immersed in the material world, the pleasures of the world. The bride has not prepared herself for the bridegroom. That's why the Lord is waiting patiently. The Lord is working on us. It took only 6 days for God to create the whole universe, the whole creation, human beings and animals and everything. But it is taking a lifetime for Him to prepare us for His coming. He is patiently working on us. He is gracious towards us. He is merciful towards us. Now, we also need to have the patience to wait for Him, for His second coming. There is a small story like that. Two young boys got married in one village and they had to go to Gulf for jobs after the marriage. Then they stayed in Gulf for 2 years and suddenly they disappeared due to some terrorists. And for 1 or 2 years, there was no trace of them. Their wives, the two women, waited for them 1 year, 2 years. But one lady lost the patience. And she started having an affair with another man. But one lady was faithful. She was waiting for her husband. She loved her husband very much. She says, "My husband will come one day. He is alive. I don't believe that he is dead. He will come one day. He loves me. I will wait for him." But the another lady, she had no patience. She said, "Why to waste my youth? I don't know whether my husband will come or not. Let me enjoy." And she started having affair with another man. Suddenly, one day, the terrorist released these two young men and they came to India without informing their wives. Both of them were so much joyful. They wanted to give surprise to their wives. When they came home, one man went and saw a open door and his wife was waiting. When she saw him, she clung to him. She cried. She kissed him publicly. But another man, when he went to his house, the door was closed. When he banged the door, slowly one lady opened the door. She was ashamed to see her husband's face because her lover was inside. She was enjoying with her lover. She forgot about her husband because she had no patience. Then afterwards, we came to know that lady committed suicide because she could not show her face to her husband. She lost her patience. But another lady was joyful because she loved and she waited for her husband. She had patience in hope. My dear brothers and sisters, now we saw three characteristics of a true Christian. The first one, work of faith. Second one, labor of love. Third one, patience in hope. Let us examine ourselves. If we are really true Christians, we need all three virtues. Works of faith, labor of love, patience in hope. May God grant us these virtues and help us to be true Christians. My dear brothers and sisters, let us be not only simply Sunday Christians and Monday to Saturday worldly Christians. Let us be true Christians, like the believers at Thessalonica, whom the great Apostle Paul said, "You are the model and example for other churches." When people look at us, they should say, these people are the true Christians. Shall we close our eyes before the Lord? Let us examine for a moment and ask us to give these three characteristics of Thessalonican church in our lives. I will pray for you. Our gracious and loving Father, we thank you and praise you for this wonderful time you have granted to us. Thank you, Lord, for speaking to us from 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 3, about three characteristics of the Thessalonican believers. Lord, we know. We have so many shortcuts. We have so many weaknesses. But yet we want all these three characteristics evident and manifested in our life for your glory and kingdom. We ask you this in the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.